Hirakud Dam seems to be the world's longest earthen dam. It stands across the mighty river, Mahanadi, in the Sambalpur region of Orissa. The objectives of this Hirakud hydroelectric project were to manage floods, provide water for cultivation, and generate electricity. It was the first major multi-purpose river valley project after India's independence in 1947. The upper drainage basin of the Mahanadi River is known for two contrasting phenomena: periodic droughts on the upper delta region, and floods in the lower delta region. In the upper drainage basin of the Mahanadi River, centered on the Chhattisgarh plain, periodic droughts contrast with the situation in the lower delta region where floods may damage crops. In the year 1936, the country saw a devastating flood. This flood was in the same delta. Before this flood, Bharat Ratna, Sir M. Visvesvaraya, who was a civil engineer, submitted a report about the detailed investigation of the Mahanadi Reservoir Plan. This plan aimed at tackling the problem of the Mahanadi Delta. Sir M. Visvesvaraya was the Diwan of Mysore. India is celebrating September 15, every year, as National Engineers Day on his birthday. In 1945, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was the member of Labour in Government of India during that time, took the decision to utilize the potentiality of River Mahanadi in the most fruitful ways. The Central Waterways Navigation and Irrigation Commission took the project. Then Governor of Orissa, Sir Hofrone Lewis, led the foundation stone of Hirakud Dam on the 15th of March 1946. In June of 1947, the project report was then submitted to the Government of India. The dam was constructed to help alleviate these problems by creating a reservoir and controlling river flow through the drainage system. The dam regulates the flow of the Mahanadi River and produces hydroelectricity through several hydroelectric plants. Thus, the construction of the world's longest dam began. As a country that just got freedom, this project was a crowning project. Machines supported man's efforts. It was a huge project, and it is a landmark project that made the country proud. Hundreds of workers are replaced by bulldozers and machinery. The dikes are a key part of the dam. They ensure excellent water storage. Although the dam's main goal was to reduce floods, the building of such a large dam project resulted in the eviction of numerous locals in West Orissa. Over 1.5 lakhs individuals and over 22,000 households were relocated due to it. They are aware that the operations have been launched to reclaim new land for them. The administration had initially intended to pay well over $120 million to such afflicted families. However, the updated accounts reveal an allotment of just over $95 million. After months of arduous work, concrete is now being laid. It will protect the dam's body. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru laid the first batch of concrete on the 12th of April 1948. The dam is a composite structure of concrete, masonry, and earth. In India, dams have proved to be sustainable. The usability of these dams is many, and they are the most efficient way of utilizing the water resources of the country. It made India self-reliant. The free India as a country was still a child, and such decisions made the country stronger. The Hirakud Dam is built of several components with a lot of technical composition and formations. Granite along with hard concrete and earth are the mostly used substances in building of the gigantic structure of the Hirakud Dam. It is stretched from the Chandidangi Hills on the right to the Lamdingri Hills on left. The main section of the dam has a length of 4.8 kilometers and is flanked by dikes on both sides with a total length of 25.8 kilometers with dikes. The years go by. The work at the dam site continues ongoing. The basic structure of this multi-purpose project could be observed. There are two separate hydroelectric powerhouses supported by the dam. The project's outline is gradually taking form. Engineers inspect the construction site. Hirakud Dam is not just a dam. It is an engineering marvel and an example of human competency to overcome the challenges put by nature. It shows that with an effort, a problem that seemed insurmountable at first can be solved efficiently. It also forms the biggest artificial lake in Asia, with a reservoir holding 743 square kilometers at full capacity, with a shoreline of over 639 kilometers. Water is a natural resource that's depleting day by day. Projects like this help the human race in conserving and optimally utilizing the water resources. Sustainable development is the key to success. Building dams on vast rivers is one such development sign. Prime Minister Nehru visits the construction site to observe the progress of the work. The Hirakud Dam is more than a dam. It's a matter of pride altogether. After the independence of India, this was the first river valley project. The dam was completed in 1953 and was formally inaugurated by Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru on the 13th of January 1957. The Great River is now under control, thanks to the 16-mile-long dam, a man-made mountain of soil, stone, and concrete that stores the water that has been drained from a region of nearly 32,000 square miles. This water will not flood the valley, but will instead turn the turbines of the power plant, generating electric energy that can be delivered hundreds of miles to cities and villages. It has constructed new canals in the valley, the first of a massive irrigation system that will be arranged to sustain and enhance Orissa's agriculture. The total cost of the project was over 100 crore rupees in 1957. Power generation along with agricultural irrigation started in 1956, achieving full potential in 1966.